Hey guys, welcome to Scott's Creations. Today we're going to turn a wine bottle into a candle. This is a fun, inexpensive project. You already have the bottle, and hopefully you enjoy drinking the wine. This could make a good gift, or this could be maybe a way to remember a special evening with your significant other. One might even think it could be romantic.
When the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
Okay, let me go grab the stuff we need, and we'll get ready. The small pot I'm going to use for making the candle, for popping the top off, and the big one we're going to use with our wax inside here. We're going to start getting it warm. I've got a little leftover from last time we're going to keep going with. And let's start working on getting this bottle cut off. All right, this is our bottle cutter. Got a little thumb screw on here. Just want to set it up. That's going to work for us. That way is going to work for us. So here's our cutter. I'll put the bottle on. Make sure it's sitting nice and flush on there. And then we're just going to want to set our stop. So we keep our label. Right about there looks pretty good, which is all the way at the stop anyway. Tighten it down. Cut her up a little bit. All right, so now we want to be careful with this. Take our time. Only get one shot to do it. I'm gonna pull it firmly against the stop and start turning it. You can hear it scoring the bottle. We want one continuous score. I don't know if you can see this. I hope you can. You can see the score we put in the bottle. I jacked it up a little bit right there. That's why you got to be careful. We'll see what we end up with. Hopefully we won't have to do too much sanding. But let's give it a whirl. So we're going to alternate hot water, cold water. Get it to expand and pop the top off. All right, so all we're going to do now is heat the bottle and cool the bottle. Heat the bottle, cool the bottle. Don't burn yourself, cut yourself, all that good stuff. Cold water. Hot water. I guess you know what's coming next, huh? Eventually it should fail here. There you go. Pretty clean cut, we got lucky. Let's go to the next step. Okay, so we have our cut bottle. Obviously, we don't want anybody to get cut, so we're gonna start wet sanding this. 80 grit. One 20 grit. Two 20 grit. Three 20 grit. 400 grit. 600 grit. You can keep going if you want. 600 is plenty for me. Got 7,000 in the garage we'll use for some of that other project. But for this guy, nobody's gonna get cut. We're doing good. All right, let's give it a rinse. And there you go. There's our free candle. We'll check on the wax, see what it's doing, get this dried out, and we'll get our wick put in. Go from there. Okay, so our wax is starting to melt. I have it some leftover from a previous project, but you see we don't have the pot with the wax in it. It's a pot of water. It's not directly in there itself. It's starting to melt. Slowly but surely. Let's throw a little more and make sure we got enough. All right, I'm just going to add a little wax. All right, so we have our cut-off bottle. Got our wicks. And I'm going to plug in my glue gun, just some hot glue gun. And once that guy dry, or heats up, we will glue our wick in. Should fit pretty good. All right, be right back. You guys don't need to do it this way, but I'm gonna because I happen to have mechanical fingers in the garage. You can use a screwdriver, or anything you got to sit down the bottle, you know, that you can get your hand down in there and glue it to the bottom of the bottle. And I'm gonna use this clothespin here because I happen to have it in a drawer, but we'll use it in a later step too. That'll just hold it up for me for right now. I'm going to take our glue gun, put a decent amount of glue on there, because the bottom's round. Let's glue it in. Now we wait. Hot glue dries pretty quick. Alright, our wick is installed and glued in there. Give it a little time before we start messing around with it. Let's check on our wax. Our wax is getting there slowly but surely, so we just need something to keep this wick centered up while the wax dries again. So I just grabbed a skewer from the kitchen. And I am going to wrap it around. Keep it relatively centered up, and I'm going to use my clothespin again to hold it. That way when it dries, it'll be centered in there. And now we just wait for the wax to melt. While we're waiting, maybe we can try a can too. Full disclosure, I'm making this up as I go along. We got some time while I wait for it to dry, so I'm gonna take a rotary file and I'll put it on my drill. We're gonna see what happens. That's gonna take forever. Try something else. So it's not super pretty, but it worked. Just take off. Alright, so it's cleaned up. I don't know, let's give it a try. I've never done this before. Alright, so it's gonna be the same routine as the wine bottle. Plug the glue gun back in. Another wick. Get on there, sucker. Alright. Wait for the glue gun to heat up. Alright, so we'll just repeat the same process we do with our beer can experiment. Give her a generous amount again. Pop her in there. Give it a sec to set up. All right, I'll set the top up like I did for the wine bottle, and then we'll, once the wax is done, we'll... All right, so do the same routine. Alright guys, so our wax is finally done melting.
Oh, fucked up pretty quick there.
Alright, I'm going to pour the beer can first because that's not really what you're here for. I kind of slid the wick out of the way to give me a little bit more room to pour. Sucker's hot. Alright, let's pour what we came here for. Now we're just going to let them sit and dry, and we'll be back tomorrow to see what they look like.
All right, I moved them out of the kitchen because I want them to be still, and there's a lot of activity in there. As you can see, they're still translucent. And once they cure, we'll cut them and line them tomorrow, see what we got. All right, guys, see you tomorrow.
All right, guys, the candles have cured, so all we have to do is take off our little rig here. Cut the wick to length.
Guys, so that's a wrap. Simple, fun project that's sure to please anyone. Let's give them a light. I'd say that's successful. Have a good one.